Can everyone remain standing and join me for the Pledge of Allegiance? Can everyone remain standing? And now join me for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may now be seated.
Would you please stand again for the national anthem, which will be signed by Jaden Penhallow. You may now take your seats. Good evening and welcome. It is my privilege and honor to welcome you to the graduation exercises of Claremont Academy's Class of 2023. I am Principal Angela Plant, and I am very pleased to be joining all of you this evening as we pay tribute to this graduating class. Mayor Joseph Petty, School Committee Member Laura Clancy, School Committee Member Tracy Novick, and other distinguished city officials, Superintendent Dr. Rachel Menares, South Quadrant Executive Director Dr. Timothy Sippel, Ms. Katarina Kambosos, Mr. Booker Lester, dedicated faculty, proud caregivers, friends, and of course, our graduates. Tonight is the night that you have dreamed of, studied for, and beat so many odds to be here. However, before I begin my remarks, I'm going to ask that we all take a moment of silence to recognize and honor Coach Al Jenkins. Coach Al was our varsity girls basketball coach who passed away this school year. His hard work, friendship to many, and commitment to education is a part of the collective accomplishments for this evening. Thank you, Coach Al. I also want to say thank you to Hanover Theatre for hosting this event this evening. I'm going to take this opportunity to go over my yearbook letter as one last lesson to these soon-to-be graduates. I know that many of you may be filled with excitement, a little worry, some relief, now that you are here and you've completed the final days of your high school career. Some of you realize now how fast the time flew by and how quickly this year started and has now come to end. As you look back on this time in your life and continue to plan your future, I hope that you have been that there have been valuable lessons learned along the way. All of us here at Claremont Academy wish you the very best that life has to offer, and I want to leave you with a few words of wisdom. Never give up. Never give up. Anything you want can be achieved through hard work, perseverance, and goal setting. For some of our scholars, this has meant overcoming tremendous obstacles and challenges. Challenges that were just dealt, and challenges that you may have put in your own path. Learning how to keep going, asking for help, or just showing up has earned you this moment and this diploma. So never give up. Trust yourself, your instincts, and that small voice inside that guides you from right and wrong. When you are faced with decisions or situations that seem impossible, trust yourself enough to not make blind, split-second decisions and to call on your past experiences, current knowledge, and belief in right over wrong. Be the ally, role model, friend, or confidant that may be needed in a time of trouble. Doing that for others will return to you in your time of need. Can't nobody do you like you? That may not be grammatically correct sentence, but as Mr. John Bryan, our grade 11 English teacher, commented to me a few days ago, he said, "I'm a firm believer that grammar should be descriptive rather than prescriptive." So here I'm being descriptive. My point here is to be true to yourself, your beliefs, values, or ideas. They may change over time, but be truth seekers in all that you do, so that the real you shows up every time. Dr. Seuss said it best, "Today you are you, that is truer than true. There is no one alive who is youer than you." Stand up for what you believe in and always stand up for yourself. There are many ways to do that. Start by taking good care of yourself, mentally and physically. A sound heart and mind is key to a healthy and happy life. Ubuntu is everything. I am stronger because of all of you, and you are stronger, wiser, and better because of all of us. Our community has grown because of your willingness to hold each other accountable, because of your willingness to lift each other up, and because you have changed each other. From the seniors who walked the seventh grader to class, to that seventh grader who made posters for you at the senior grad walk, to the seniors who have now realized that they should have cherished their time at Claremont a bit more and taken it more seriously, who have now offered a mentoring program to give back to middle school students for next year, to our seniors who just joined us during their high school years, who were timid, shy, and soft-spoken, who now demonstrate some of the greatest school spirit and the greatest growth in their academic success. Ubuntu is everything. I look forward to hearing, seeing, and learning all of the great things that you will do in our community and beyond. It has truly been a pleasure these past 5 years to be your principal, your planta, your bestie, and dare I say it, your very old version of Ice Spice. Congratulations. Felicidades. And now I will ask for Ms. Carlson and Ms. Coleman to come forward for presentation of awards.
congratulations, class of 2023. I'm going to take a moment to honor our John and Abigail Adams Scholarship recipients. The John and Abigail Adams Scholarship provides a tuition credit for up to 8 semesters of undergraduate education at a Massachusetts state college or university. Eligibility to earn a John and Abigail Adams Scholarship is based on students' first-time test scores on high school MCAS tests. Scholarships are granted to students whose combined score places them in the top 25% of students in their district and who also meet the MCAS score requirements. Would the following John and Abigail Adams scholars please stand and stay standing so we can applaud you? Johan Brito. Marcus Hayes. Amy Lee. Tina Nguyen. Say Ray. And Adriel Vasquez. Congratulations, you can now be seated. And now Ms. Carlson will announce some senior awards.
Good evening. It is an honor and a privilege to present these awards to our students, and these have been selected by all of their teachers, and there weren't too many fights, just a few, but we worked it out on who was going to be getting what. So first, very proud to announce Excellence in Science, Sergio Osorio. Sorry, for these you gotta move. There was a tie for this one, Excellence in ELA. There are two awards. The first goes to Marcus Hayes. And the second goes to Michelle Portillo. Excellence in Theater, Jason Rivas Cicolano. Excellence in Art, Millie Navarro Brito. Now, art is a very varied medium, and we had one student that excelled in one area of art that had to be recognized. Excellence in Painting, Daniel Cerna. I know this one is going to get a loud applause. Excellence in Music, Brianna Santos Lopez.
place won't be the same without our drums. Excellence in technology, Fu Nguyen. Excellence in social studies, Eric Aravalo Quintanilla. Excellence in Spanish, Millie Navarro Brito. Excellence in ASL, Jaden Penhollow. Excellence in math, Tina Nguyen. At this point, I'm going to give out the award for excellence in ELL, and I'm going to put in a shameless plug for our ELL night classes at Claremont that are completely free on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 5:30 to 8, and you're all welcome. And the reason why I mention it is because this young man came to night school after he did day school. So the award for excellence in ELL goes to Abraham Belize Orleans. Came with his parents. It was the cutest thing I've ever seen. The next award is for academic achievement, and this is for a student that has gone above and beyond to achieve academically. And this award goes to Jeremy Ferrara Polino. The School Spirit Award, give me a P. No, I'm just kidding. It's Pamela Dodeco. The next award is our Good Citizen Award, and that goes to Arielis Rivera. The last award that I'm giving out is for perfect attendance. Perfect in every way for all the years at Claremont. And that goes to Michelle Portilla. I'd like to invite Mrs. Clamp back up to the podium to give out a few special awards.
Thank you both. We have a long-standing tradition here at Claremont that the principal acknowledges graduates with two personal awards. The first award is based on one of our six characteristics, Ubuntu, an African proverb that means, I am because we are. This award is presented to a student who demonstrates that sense of belonging, responsibility, collective work via collaboration, and a strong sense of community. The student who is receiving this award this evening is like the school mayor. Everyone from grade 7 to Woodland teachers and staff know this student. She is welcoming to all, speaks on behalf of many, and quite honestly, it's going to take me some time to get used to not seeing her in the hallways or at every after-school event that we have. Although I have a feeling she will show up even after graduation tonight. The 2023 Ubuntu Award goes to Larima Foster Reyes. The Principal's Award, I had some difficulty in choosing and deciding who would receive this award. The Principal's Award seeks to honor a student who has demonstrated growth and/or progress in their time at Claremont. That growth may be personally, academically, or both. And for this evening, I decided to break with tradition and award two students because both have shown growth and progress in very different ways. Here is another great lesson. Everyone's circumstances are unique to them. So tonight, the first Principal's Award goes to Nem Cruz. And the second Principal's Award goes to Escarlene Martinez. Thank you. Mayor Joseph Petty is the Executive Secretary to the Employees Retirement System of the Massachusetts Housing Finance Agency and is serving his 13th two-year term as Councilor at Large and his sixth term as Mayor of the City of Worcester, our City of Worcester and Worcester School Committee. Mayor Petty is a graduate of the former Holy Name Central Catholic High School. He earned a Bachelor's of Science in Business Administration from Nichols College and a law degree from New England School of Law in Boston. Mayor Petty is a champion of the public school system, of green spaces in our city, and a respected community leader. Please welcome to the stage, or to the podium, Mayor Joseph Petty.
Good evening, everyone. School committee members, Laura Clancy, Tracy O'Connor-Novick, Superintendent Marez, Executive Director Tim Sippo, Principal Angela Plant, and our educators, our paraeducators, our whole staff. I just want to thank you for everything you've done over the last year, over the last several years, especially during COVID. You made a difference in people's lives. Thank you very much. You did a great job. Much appreciated. And by the way, you're really sharp tonight, too. So, and to the parents, families, and friends of the class, and also to the class of 2023. I just want to congratulate all the award winners here tonight. And on this stage tonight, we also have 18 sealed biliteracy recipients in the language of Spanish, Vietnamese, and American Sign Language. One of our students has also received an $80,000 scholarship. Congratulations. And tonight's valedictorian received the Great Minds Scholarship to WPI. Congratulations. Now, Claremont Academy is a special place. Over the last 4 years, we've been nurtured by the community, an open and welcoming community. As you move forward from this place, I hope that you'll find a community like the one you have here. Wherever you go, help build community like the one you experienced here in the city of Worcester. Be open and welcome to everyone. Find the values in everyone. You share with them the experience of you had at Claremont, and you'll see the change you can create. And as you embark on the next chapter of your lives, I want to take a moment to talk about the importance of leadership in the face of new and unexpected challenges. Throughout your education, you have undoubtedly faced many roadblocks, obstacles, and challenges. There have been moments of doubt, uncertainty, and fear, but you have persevered and overcome these challenges through your hard work, dedication, and leadership. Now, as you move forward into the world beyond school, new challenges await you. Challenges that you may not have anticipated or not prepared for. But it's precisely in these moments of uncertainty where leadership is most necessary. Leadership is not about having all the answers or being in complete control. It's about having the courage to face challenges head on, to take risks, and to learn from failures. Leadership is about being adaptable, flexible, and resilient in the face of adversity. It's important to recognize that leadership doesn't come from a title or a position of authority. Leadership is a quality that can be demonstrated in any situation by anyone. It is found in the person who steps up to lead a group project or one who helps a struggling classmate. It is found in everyday moments of kindness, compassion, and empathy. Leadership isn't always easy, but it is essential, especially in times of crisis. The COVID-19 pandemic has highlighted the need for strong leadership, and many of you have stepped up to become leaders in your community. You have shown resilience, creativity, and dedication in the face of immense challenges. As you move forward into the next chapter of your life, I encourage you to embrace uncertainty and challenges with the same spirit of leadership that has carried you this far. Whether you're starting a new job, pursuing for education, entering the military, or simply navigating life's unpredictable twists and turns. Remember that leadership is not just a quality to be admired, but a quality to be cultivated. Congratulations to you. I wish you all the best in your future endeavors, and I have no doubt that you'll continue to be leaders in your communities wherever life takes you. Congratulations.
School Committee member Laura Clancy is serving her second term on the Worcester School Committee. She is chair of the Standing Committee for Governance and Employee Issues and a member of the Standing Committee for School and Student Performance. Laura earned a bachelor's degree in early child education and psychology from Worcester State University and was awarded a master's degree in educational psychology from American International College. She is also a certified high school guidance counselor. Laura has worked as an educator for over 20 years, where she has worked as a teacher and in the last 17 years in her current role as education and career counselor in partnership with the Department of Youth Services, where she works as an educational advocate for at-risk youth and their families in numerous school districts across Central Mass. Laura has two daughters, Addison, who is a sophomore at Doherty High School, and a six-year-old Tegan, who is a kindergartner at Nelson Place. Please welcome school committee member Laura Clancy to the podium.
Thank you. Good evening, graduates, parents, families, Principal Plant, educators, Superintendent Monterez, Mayor Petty. It is a privilege and an honor to be here this evening and to watch each of you as you walk across the stage as part of the graduating class of 2023 from Claremont Academy. And I promise to be quick, because I know how much you're anticipating walking across this stage. So first of all, I would like to thank our incredible educators in this theater. No matter what your job title is in our school department, each and every one of you has played a pivotal role in helping these graduates achieve this goal. And I thank you for your incredible work. Just look at these graduates. It was all worth it. To the families here today, this is just as much of a celebration for you as it is for our graduates. I know the past 12 plus years have not been easy for you. And as parents, and as we know, our job as parents will never end, but you deserve to take this time and celebrate. For you have been able to get these students through some of the most difficult times of their lives, and it's time for them to fly. Graduates, congratulations. You made it. You should be so proud of your accomplishments. As I was gathering my thoughts for this little speech today, I started to look back on the last four years when you were in high school. And we faced a pandemic, many social injustices, violence, world leaders showing us exactly how not to act, Tom Brady winning a Super Bowl for another team other than the Patriots. And I'm sure each of you have had your own personal battles over these years. Through all of this, you were able to focus, to build resilience, to get through and here today. And the craziness of the world will continue, and there will be some really rough times. But remember, tough times don't last, tough people do. And whether you're going off to college, vocational training, the military, the workforce, and for those of you who are still thinking about your next steps, these are the things you will have learned throughout your time in school that will help you lead your success wherever you go. Things like decision-making, communication, critical thinking. You see, it's not all about the test scores and grades. It's about those other things that have made you who you are. And as you continue to grow as a person, those will be the skills that you carry. So just remember, life goes so fast. Enjoy every moment. Not so long ago, you were little kindergartners walking into a building and starting your role as a student. And now look at where you are and just how fast that went by. Enjoy these moments, and I wish the best of you in your next adventure that lies ahead. Congratulations.
Superintendent Dr. Rachel Menades believes in the possibility of every child, and this approach will guide her daily interactions as the superintendent of Worcester Public Schools. Beginning her 29th year of education, Dr. Menares holds a vast knowledge base for academic excellence, professional development, and collaborative practices. Dr. Menares has served as a teacher, school principal, director of English learner programs and special education, assistant superintendent, and deputy superintendent. As a social justice champion, she works collaboratively with all stakeholders to foster a culture of equity, academic excellence, and high expectations for all learners. Her favorite quote is, excellence can be attained if you care more than others think is wise, risk more than others think is safe, dream more than others think is practical, and expect more than others that it is possible. Dr. Menares received a Bachelor of Arts in History from UC Irvine, a Master's in Education, and a PhD from Claremont Graduate University with an emphasis in urban education. She's the proud mother of Natalie, an emerging writer, teacher, and poet, and married to Jesus Menares, a retired educator. Please welcome Dr. Rachel Menares.
All right, before I get started, I have to do the selfie, right? Okay, so I just learned what a 0.5 is, and I was trying, thinking, this, I can't do it yet. Okay, so we're just gonna have to, So I'm gonna go over here, we're gonna remember, this goes out to everybody, so we wanna represent WPS well. 1 second, parents. I'm happy to see we're all wearing the correct colors to this evening, right? My last graduation this year, so please indulge me. It's kind of fun, right? Good evening, everybody. from our distinguished guests on the stage, our dedicated educators, thank you so much for being here, our proud families, community members, and of course, the incredible graduates of 2023. So I do realize I am the last adult that is in the way of getting those diplomas, aside from you hearing from your class president, so I'm going to do my best to not bore you with adult language, but still give you some advice here, all right? So together as we gather here to celebrate one of life's many milestones, it is the culmination of years of hard work, growth, and discovery. And I really did go back and forth on which quote I'm going to use, and there's a theme that seems to be running through, and so I'm going with the theme of the great words of Dr. Seuss. Oh, the places you'll go, you're off to great places, and today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. Graduates, you are about to embark on a journey filled with infinite possibilities. And I want to remind you that everything you need lies within you, because you are from Worcester. Throughout your educational journey, you've encountered challenges, including, as we heard and we know, a pandemic. You've overcome obstacles, learned the value of teamwork, community, and collaboration, especially graduating from Claremont Academy. You've developed friendships and mentors, discovered your passions, and owned your talents. So whether your passion was in athletics, early college opportunities, student government, I want you to always remember to embrace your unique voice, su cultura y su idioma. Your individuality is your greatest strength. It is your greatest asset. Stay passionate and persistent. Stay true to your passion, even during challenging times, and be prepared for those rejections and setbacks. That's just what life is about, and it only makes you stronger, so learn from them. That's what makes you the best person you can be. Continuously learn and grow, build a supportive network, embrace failures as that stepping stone, and most of all, stay authentic and true to who you are. And despite some of what you may hear about what the world holds, it's actually a really exciting time to embark on this next chapter. There's a vast array of opportunities to explore and pursue your passions. New industries, technologies, career paths, they're emerging every day. They're offering diverse and exciting prospects for personal and professional growth. And I can't imagine a group of scholars who are not as more prepared than ever than this group sitting in front of me. You are innovative thinkers, and you will solve some of the most complex challenges that exist in our world. And actually, we're kind of counting on you, so no pressure or anything. Rapid technology advancements are shaping our world in extraordinary ways. Breakthroughs in fields like artificial intelligence, renewable energy, and biotechnology. These are all necessary for us to learn how to solve complex problems. So again, we're counting on you, your innovative spirits, to lead the way in fields that do not even exist yet. And still, with the rise of these technologies, we'll always need highly skilled workers in trades like construction, like electronics, like nursing, and of course, education. Who wants to come work for Worcester Public Schools? Raise your hand. Yeah, I want to get those names right there, right there. You know, Ms. Plant, the educators at Claremont Academy and Woodland Academy were your greatest cheerleaders. And so as you step into the world, remember that life is filled with adventures, ups and downs, twists and turns. There will be moments of triumph and moments of defeat, moments of clarity and moments of confusion. Embrace each one, do not be afraid to take risks, explore uncharted territories, and just chase your dreams, and have fun while you do it. Cherish your relationships that you form along the way. Stay true to yourself, true to your family, do what's right and just live your life authentically. And I cannot reiterate and restate, own who you are. Su cultura, su idioma, your culture, your language. That is what makes you who you are. And it makes you authentic. And it makes you, you. Unless you're a twin. Any twins out here? Okay, so you're all unique to yourselves, as far as you know, right? So class of 2023, as you step into the world beyond these walls, know that you have the power to create a future that is bright, inspiring, and full of promise. Embrace the challenges that lie ahead, for they will shape you into the extraordinary individuals you're destined to become. Oh, the places you go, you're off to great places, and today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. Congratulations, felicidades, class of 2023. May your journey be filled with endless opportunities, unyielding courage, and boundless joy. Adelante a todos. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor Petty, School Committee Member Laura Clancy, and Superintendent Menares. As some of you may know, Claremont is one of the only schools in the district that offers ASL. So at this time, we will have a presentation from our ASL students.
This is me. I can't see right through.
is Claremont. I can't tell you how proud I am of our students and those presentations. Every year, they're just thrilling and get better and better. Congratulations. At this time, we will hear from our two class speakers. First, class president, Brianna Santos.
Oh my God. It's a lot. All right. Before I get started, I would like to thank the 50 people who are here for me tonight. And the rest of my family that will be watching this. You guys mean a lot to me. I wanted to give a special thank you to my parents, the ones who sacrificed it all for me, the ones who arrived to this country with nothing and gave me all. Mami, papi, gracias por todo lo que hacen por mí. Por levantarse cada día y luchar para darme el mejor futuro. Gracias por su consejo y amor incondicional. Yo soy quien soy por ustedes, y como pueden ver, todo lo que han hecho por mí no fue en vano, que ahora en este día pueden ver los frutos de lo que han cosechado. Esto es por ustedes, y a mi abuela, que va a estar viendo esto desde Salvador, igual a mis abuelos que están hoy aquí acompañándome, los amo. Y para las familias hispanas que están hoy aquí, les quiero decir que todo lo que sus hijos han logrado es por su amor y motivación hacia ellos. Entonces, este día es para celebrarles a todos ustedes también. All right, let me get started. Good evening, family, friends, faculty, and dignitaries, and a special welcome to the graduates of the class of 2023. My name is Brianna Santos Lopez, and it's my honor to be up here speaking to all of you as senior class president at Claremont Academy. Before we begin, I would like to take a moment to thank all of our fantastic teachers and mentors, advisors, coaches that got us all here today. Without their wisdom, guidance, unconditional support, and a whole lot of patience, each and every one of us would not be up here on this stage. Begin clapping. Today, for one last time, we are all together, concluding another chapter of our lives. I hope that this is only the first of many victories to come for the class of 2023. We have come a long way, and it was not easy for us to get here. There were many obstacles that tried to stop us on our journey, but we fought and made it. In the end, it didn't matter how we got here. Whether we flew, crawled, or walked, we didn't give up. And now we get to sit where many others have sat before us. Here at Claremont Academy, we have been blessed with many unique experiences, both positive and negative. I had the best laughs. One memory I have in particular is in middle school with my best friend Sergio. We had the best time together, same schedule, same lunch, and then they changed our classes. We talked a lot, that's why. I miss hanging out with Sergio. Not necessarily his jokes, but it's all good. We had so many other highlights as well. This group in particular seems to have a knack for getting hurt. We could be named the class of injuries. I sprained my ankle, the Annabelle's ankle, Weardy's ankle, Isaiah multiple sprained ankles, Olivia in her countless concussions, Loida's ankle, Carlos's ankle, Wyler, Scarlett hurting her knee. How about we do it like this? Just show hands on how many of you have pulled, twisted, or something. I have. Yes, Moyardi, Mr. Matthews, raise your hand. You gotta raise that hand. I was trying to think of something to say, stories to share, advice to give, but that's just not me. Instead, I wanted to leave you with something different. Something that means something to us Main South Claremont kids. When I asked some of the seniors, what is something only a Claremont kid would get? I got responses like, we turn everything into dance parties, or we come from a dance school, we have Ubuntu, March Madness. The responses are all different, but there was one common thing among them, we, Ubuntu. Mrs. Plain has drilled this word into us to the point where we sometimes might even roll our eyes, but it's true. Up to this point, we have had a few experiences that didn't involve or impact us, all of us, our identities, our experiences, our passions, our failures, and our successes. They have all been intertwined to make us the class of 2023. But after this, that us changes. This chapter ends. Our stories might cross again one day, but it will never be like this, like it has been for as long as we've been students. As we go out and begin the next phase of our lives, we need to find our new we. We need to seek out those who have our backs, who want the best for us, and want to see us succeed. We need to find that system because we cannot do this by ourselves. One thing about us humans, we sometimes believe we are capable of doing things on our own with no hope. But as a spiritual person, I believe that without God, things are impossible. But also, things are impossible without the people God has put in our lives to support us and push us to be the best versions of ourselves. Although Ubuntu might be only something Claremont kids will get, it is a philosophy to live by. We cannot do this on our own. Our academic careers have shown us that. We need that we. When times are tough, when we want to rejoice, when we need a reality check, we need each other. We cannot make things better or change the world by ourselves. We need our community. We need our we. We need Ubuntu. Almost done. So I hope you keep in mind, I am because we are. Because if we got no hope, then who's going to help us? Congratulations to the class of 2023. We finally made it. God bless you all.
Great job, Brianna. Our next class speaker is Amy Lee, our valedictorian.
Hi. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, esteemed faculty, proud parents, and my fellow graduates. Today is a momentous occasion, a day filled with both joy and bittersweet nostalgia. As we're about to enter this new chapter of our lives and begin on separate roads, I can't help but feel sad that high school is already over. We have spent years growing up together, and it feels like just yesterday we walked through those school doors as freshmen, wide-eyed and unsure what the future held. And yet, here we are, transformed, prepared to leave behind the familiar and embrace the unknown. In this time together, we have witnessed growth and transformation. The experience of these past 4 years has molded us into people we may have not thought we would be, but instead exactly who we needed to be. We have seen the quiet ones find their voices, the dreamers discover their passions, and the timid souls like mine become fearless leaders. I mean, if you had told younger me that I'd be giving a speech to all of you today, I would not believe you. As we stand here, filled with anticipation for what lies ahead, it's essential to recognize that this day also marks the end of an era. We will be scattered far and wide, venturing into the vast unknown, pursuing our dreams and carving out our paths. Some of us will go to college, while others will enter the workforce or embark on other remarkable journeys. I smile thinking about the future careers of the graduates here today. Some of us will become great teachers, nurses, lawyers, mechanics. Just know that the possibilities are endless when it comes to this hardworking class. And though we may be separated by distance and time, the lessons we have learned and the memories we have shared will forever be etched in our hearts. When I think back to my time here at Claremont, I think about playing cards in the cafeteria, the friendships I made in all the late nights doing assignments because I was cursed with being a chronic procrastinator, the sweet yet ridiculous happy birthday song Mr. Moriarty plays for our birthdays, and watching the pie eating contest hosted by Miss Amy are just two of my many favorite class memories. Going to prom, the senior trip to Connecticut, and our class trip to Ocean Beach were my absolute favorite times I got to spend with this wonderful class. I also appreciate the unique traditions Claremont upholds, like the Rap Fair, Gateway Presentations, Ubuntu Cup, and my favorite coffee house. In closing, I want to express my gratitude to every one of you for the incredible relationships we have forged, the memories we have made at Claremont, and the support we have given one another. I also want to express appreciation for my parents for always pushing me towards greatness and building a life for us here in the U.S. As we go forth from this day, let us seize every opportunity that comes our way, embrace the challenges, and strive for greatness. Congratulations, class of 2023. We have grown up together, and now it's time to spread our wings and soar. May we leave a lasting impact on the world as we have on each other.
Great job, Amy. And just before we begin the presentation of diplomas, I would ask at this moment if Amber Puglia and Adelina Zaimi would step forward, please. This is just a little something on behalf of all of us to say thank you for their many years of hard work and leadership as senior class advisors. Thank you very much for all of your hard work. And now, the moment that we have all been waiting for, presentation of diplomas.
First row, please rise. Oscar L. Mendoza, honors. Bonilla Andrade. Eric Arbello Quintinoa, high honors. Spanish high honors, and bilingual Spanish. Karen Avila Cantalina. Delma Brito. Danabel Camilo Garcia. High Honors, National Honor Society. Spanish Honor Society. Spanish Seal of Biliteracy. Marvin Candace Cruz. Honors, National Honor Society. Spanish Honor Society. Spanish Seal of Biliteracy. Daniel Serna. Caitlin Cruz. Nehemias Cruz. Honors. Will the second row please rise? Jacinti Delgado. Pamela Dodecki Bango. Sophia Dahl. High Honors, National Honor Society. Camilis Encarnacion Ojeda. Honors, Spanish Honor Society. Spanish Seal of Biliteracy. Nasha Irich. Innovation Pathways Program. Angel Elzaro Reyes. Nazen Torres. Jordi's Felice Galan. Honors. Spanish Honor Society. Spanish Seal of Biliteracy. Eric Fernandez Avalos. Spanish Honor Society. Jeremy Polino, high honors. Larimar Foster Reyes. Oh, excuse me. I'm going too fast. I got you. Larimar, I got you. Lutero, please rise. Claremont, Foster, Reyes. Malkin, Garcia, High Honors. Spanish Honor Society. Darwin Gutierrez, Spanish Honor Society. Marcus Hayes, High Honors, Innovation Program, National Honor Society. Xavier Hernandez, Innovation Athlete Program. Maria Alina Aldago Melocalo, Honors, Spanish Honor Society. Olivia Chim, Honors. Giovanni Largasi, Innovation Pathways Program. Amy Lee, High Honor, National Honor Society. Pascaline Martinez Medina, High Honor, Spanish Honor Society, and Spanish Seal of Biliteracy.
Please rise. Ashford Melinda Mariano. Kala Miranda Suarez. Millie Navarro Frito. Spanish Honor Society, Spanish Seal of Biliteracy. Edwin Nebron, High Honors. Nguyen, High Honors, National Honor Society, Seal of Biliteracy in Vietnamese, Early College. Tina Nguyen, High Honors, National Honor Society. Jeremiah Okoku Mwate, Honors. Kimberly Ortega Waman. Please rise. Isaiah Cayano. Maria Peña Triana, Spanish Honor Society, Seal of Biliteracy in Spanish. Jaden Penhalo, Honor, American Sign Language for Seal of Biliteracy. Nestor Perez Pineda, Honor. Michelle Portillo, High Honors, National Honor Society, Spanish Honor Society, Seal of Biliteracy in Spanish. Sarah Salutoren, High Honors, National Honor Society. Alexander Reyes Francis. Ivalice. Row 6, please rise. Betsaida Rivera, High Honors, National Honor Society, Spanish Honor Society, Seal of Biliteracy in Spanish. Brianna Rivera. Seal of Biliteracy in Spanish. Denny Salinas. Leticia de Souza, honor. Brianna Santos Lopez, honor. Spanish Honor Society, Seal of Biliteracy in Spanish. Jason Rivas Siciliano. Loira Sierra. Yamitza Toro. Row 7, please rise. Hui Tran, high honor. Uduma. Alvin Ulerio, High Honors, National Honor Society, Spanish Honor Society, Seal of Biliteracy in Spanish. Lorraine Urbaez, Honor. Adriel Vasquez. All the graduates please rise and the valedictorian please enter to the podium. We ask that the audience remain standing while our graduates lead us out, dignitaries, and then our faculty. Thank you very much for joining us in this celebration this evening. Congratulations to the class of 2023.